I wish them well. It's been a gift to me, at the end of it all, to behold innocence. Goodbye, Zion. Randall Dean Clark, February the 5th, 2053, to January 21,
24. Yippee-yay, there'll be no wedding bells.
And we're back. And we're still close to the Red Gate, where we found the survivalist, the remains of the survivalist, a man we have come to know quite well, and who had spent an awful lot of his life contemplating blowing his own brains out, but in the end passed away relatively peacefully, watching the sun or something, I'm not totally sure, but quite peacefully apparently, having led an interesting and somewhat tragic life, but also having saved an entire people, the Sorrows, to be precise. So yeah, we're feeling pretty melancholy at the moment. Melancholy over! Melancholy moment over! Yeah, okay, yeah, well, okay, that was our moment. What the hell? What is that? It's a dog. It's a dog and...
When salt upon wounds took new
power, it just looked a little strange for a second.
The white legs to salt the earth so nothing could grow again.
Yeah,
what
okay,
What kind of monster could do that?
What was I saying? Yeah! So, anyway, things to do. We have to go and speak to Joshua and basically ask whether Follows Chalk can come with us. He wants to see civilization, and I have to say, who the hell can blame him? Not meaning anything bad about your home, he says, diplomatically. How do we get across here? Am I going to jump, do you think? Or... Oh, no, I can... Yes, I can... Do it! Jump! No? Okay. So, and we also have to talk to Daniel about what we feel he should do with regards to the White Horse. And no prizes for guessing what that's going to be, as I happen to be pretty much in agreement with the man they call Father of the Caves and consider a bit of a god. He's just a man, and I'm wearing his armour. But apparently he was a pretty tough. And in the end, kind man? No, kind's the wrong word. He liked your people and he looked after them. And I'm wearing his armor, so we're going to pretend that I've been possessed by his spirit rather than I'm having a mushy moment and feeling sorry for the Sorrows people, because that wouldn't do. That would be, you know, bleh. So yeah, we're going to go off and tell Daniel we think he should fight. And by that, what I'm probably saying is, don't worry, I'll go kill them all. Oh. Are they? I mean... I don't like scorpions, I really don't, but live and let... Okay, I was gonna say live and let live! Okay. Oh, really? Really? Stop shooting! No! No!
I need a reload!
You, that's because you keep missing! Stop! Just stop it!
I have this under control!
Tell me where he is, I'll shoot him! Is he... Oh, God. Is that him? Looks like a rock. See? Look, right? You aim down the barrel, and you have this thing at the end, the sight thing, right? Sight. Point it at what you want to hit, pull the trigger. I'd take the ammo off you because you're wasting it, other than I know you would then switch back to that giant bloody baseball mitt of yours and go running in there and get yourself killed. Yeah, I don't want to say anything mean.
Found them!
Oh, well, at least she hit this time. It's not that I'm not enjoying your company, but I really am looking forward to when you stay back at your camp. And it's not because I don't enjoy your company, it's because I really don't want to see you end up dead. I was saying something. I keep trying to say something, and... Oh yeah, I'm supposed to... I kind of wanted to double check I hadn't missed anything. I really would have... Have we... See, there's a lot of things that have not been harvested. Have we checked this caravan? I think we have, otherwise we probably would have got ourselves... Okay, she's not getting all... Well, she's not randomly shooting...
I'll fight you if I must.
Oh, now she's gonna do it. Now she's randomly shooting things.
I have this under control.
Okay. Oh, now we know where it is. Okay. Thank you. So, yeah. Okay. What are you uttering about? What are you uttering about? It's a cat. It's a caravan. I mean, they're not the most pleasant places to live, but I think is a bit too much.
It is good to travel with another. I spend so long scouting on my own that I forget what human company is like.
Forgot how to aim your weapon as well. Right, so... Oh god. Put the weapon away. You move ever so slightly faster. Where the hell are we actually going? Right, so... I don't think... we're actually gonna find anything. I think we have... checked everything out. I think we have. General store. Right. I think we're just going back to speak to Joshua. Oh, I'm so damn slow. Really am. I hate not having my weapon out while I'm running around a hostile area. But I hate moving slowly even more. We've visited there, haven't we? Yes, we've... Yeah, of course we have. Right. So, first, we find Joshua. Who... is... I feel like he should be... There we go! Oh, they're both at the same place. Well, that's kind of convenient. I will... You know, you could talk to each other rather than just reading books at each other.
Welcome back. What can I do for you?
Why would I do... I would like to know why on earth, considering the number of conversations we've had now, I would have this option. Follows Chalk C... And why is it greyed out? And why are the ones that I'm pretty sure I've said... No, okay, you know what? Never mind. I almost said that by mistake. Okay. Follows Chalk seems like he's interested in seeing more of the world.
I thought he might. It's been some time since I've visited civilized places. I don't have fond memories of them. But I have always seen these places from the outside. I'd rather not influence him more than I already do. Why don't you talk to him?
You know that means I'm going to encourage him to leave, right? I am. I can't help it. Fine by me, I prefer the wilderness. I don't mind the wilderness. It's a great place to visit for a short while. But I'm going to encourage him to leave because, hey, it's fun out there.
Falloschalk needs more guidance in his life. Just not from me.
Are you suggesting that you should take advice from me? Because if so, I have got to question your judgment. However... Yeah. Okay.
God be with you.
Right. Well, apparently, follows with Chalk's coming with us. Me. You're staying here. You're going to look after your family. Daniel!
Unless you and Joshua have any objections, I'd like to start evacuating the Sorrows. I'm going to need your help, so say your piece.
I think Joshua's right. I think you should fight. The father of the caves thinks you should fight too.
No. Why? Why? Haven't you seen enough of what's going on here to see that the Sorrows don't need to butcher the Whitelegs for a piece of land? What Joshua wants is more than an attack. He wants a slaughter. And he needs more than you and the dead horses to do it. The Sorrows can't be pushed into this. You and Joshua don't have the right to force them into it. Please, consider what I'm saying.
And you have the right to pull them off their land? This is the way the world is. They're part of it whether you like it or not. That is true, but I am questioning. Do you think you've got the right to pull them off their land? This is their land. This is their home.
I've already explained to them that we're leaving. They've accepted it. What is Joshua going to tell them about being a warrior? What are you going to tell them about how to live with themselves after they got lost in the moment, killed someone who didn't deserve to die? Or does that not matter? Is that just an acceptable consequence if it means holding on to this valley?
You said they don't deserve to die.
Maybe there is no place left in this world for mercy. But even if it tramples me into the dust, I will never accept it. And I will never condone it. Joshua must be waiting for you. I'll stay here with the others as I told them I would.
Waking Cloud has returned to the Sorrows camp, and I've got a ton of... Okay. Apparently I'm passing out. It's all that equipment.
Thank you for this. I know Daniel doesn't approve, but destroying the Whitelegs is the only way to ensure the Sorrows can remain in Zion. You and I will lead a group of Dead Horse warriors and Sorrows hunters into Three Marys from this position. Our objective is to find the Whitelegs' leader, Salt Upon Wounds, and prevent him from fleeing. Show no quarter to the Whitelegs we come across. Make no mistake about why we are here. This is an extermination.
But before we do... I was just wondering... Could I sell you some... stuff? Because I think I'm a little...
God be with you.
Joshua Graham has given you the Way of the Canaanite perk. Whilst Joshua Graham is in your party, any 45 caliber auto pistol you use has less spread and is twice as likely to cause to score critical hits. That's great. I just don't use it. Ooh.
The time for talk has passed. The Lord's work must be done.
Yeah. No, I want to...
No, thanks.
Can I not even give you some of this? Dude, you... Oh. Really, you're annoying and it's... raining and it's night time and I've got too much crap. Oh, I don't have that much crap. I don't have enough crap. Why don't I have too much crap? I've been here for ages and I don't have enough crap. I put my duffel bag on and I'm fine. That's even more annoying. And I bet you any money I could probably have skipped that stage and just gone straight to... Yeah, I could. Actually, I might as well do that while I'm here. Oh, can't repair that. Unfortunate. Okay, so I've dropped the reinforced leather armor and repaired a little stuff. I don't think I'm going to need that armor. Where the hell are we? Okay, that's the Sorrows camp. We've been kicked out of there, have we? Where are we? What are we actually? Where are we going? We're. Locate the White Legs leader, salt upon wounds, and deal with him. And that is all the way back where we came from. Of course it is. Of course it is. Let's. Right, we've got to go all the way back. Oh god, really? I've only got 19 rounds for this. I don't suppose we could go back and use the ammo bench. Did they have an ammo bench? They probably don't want us back there, do they? 19 rounds is not enough rounds. What have I got here? Okay. I've also got... Well, I got 45. I don't actually have that many rounds for that. No, I don't. I got the survival hit. Maybe I could... Oh, God, I don't have a lot of rounds for that, do I? No, I don't. Oh, God. Yeah. That does a lot of damage, but... So does that. But I really do miss my rifle. Well, I haven't lost it, and I've still got 19 rounds, but... In a nice open place like this, this is my go-to weapon. Why is it so damn dark? Oh, it's... It's night. Okay, we're creeping around in the dark while it's raining. Oh god, I don't have a lot. Well, hopefully we'll get it out of here pretty soon, so... Oh, and let's wash it down. Oh, that is better. Okay. Right, so we've got to get all the way to the White Legs camp. And then attack them, basically. Storm the castle, so to speak. I'm sure that's going to go really, really, really well. Oh! Oh god, another one. Okay, well... What? Where the... Where are they shooting? Whoa, dude. Nice one. Oh god, now I've only got 15 rounds. Oh, I've only got 15 rounds now. Bladed gauntlet. Why did I pick a bladed gauntlet up? Why did I pick up a bladed... It's not even worth much. Are we going to be running into these guys, like, all the way there? I've got a lot of purified water. Grenades. Grenades is a nice idea, isn't it? Yes, plasma grenades. Seeing as we don't have very many rifle rounds, let's lob some explosives. I just get this horrible feeling we're going to get attacked constantly. Yeah. That's the disadvantage of hotkeying that. I'm not seeing anything. I just don't want to get complacent. I don't want to put the pistol away and say to myself, okay, well, it's clear now. Let's do a bit of running. Do a bit of sprinting. Use my... Where? Nice shooting, but where? Well, I mean, partly because I'd like to know how you're spotting them, but mostly I'd like to loot them. Where were they? I felt like I was getting shot from down here. I mean, they might have bullets, mate. They might have bullets. I mean, I appreciate you're a Okay. I don't think he I don't think he had bullets, but, you never know. Nope, big flaming sword. Right. I guess that answered our question. Ooh, hello. Nah. That, of course, answered our question. Yes, we're going to be meeting these guys all the way. Are they going to ambush us from above? No, that's a cactus. A particularly dangerous and vicious looking cactus, but just a cactus nonetheless. How far are we? God, we're barely a third the way there. Run. I do appreciate that this puts me in imminent danger of coming under fire whilst out of stamina. But it's slightly less dangerous than becoming horrendously bored due to the absolutely horrendous slow nature of our movement. Whiskey's worn off. I don't want to point the weapon at you. Trust me. A bored me is a dangerous me. A sober me is an irritable me. Let's hope the cat eye lasted it. Wait, how do they do that? Out of the way, dude, out of the way or kill it. There's another one. Binoculars. I want binoculars. I've got... Yes! That is to die. Can I... I mean, I'm a good shot with this, but am I that good? Answer no. Not really. How accurate do you think this thing is? Cat eye has worn off! Lousy timing! Really lousy timing! Where is he? Really? Is it low or high or... What the... Okay, let's never use that again! What the hell is wrong with the iron sights on that thing? I'm gonna need... Oh, God. I couldn't figure out whether I was supposed to use the top of the iron sight, the bottom of the iron sights, the middle of the iron sight. Well, the middle, obviously, but I meant middle vertically, not the mid... Oh, God, what the hell was that? What the hell was that? What was that? What... Oh, it's bitter drink. Oh, God. That's... Okay. Dude. That can't be it. It wore off. It said it wore off. I'm even going in the right direction now. Yeah. Okay, really? Am I poisoned? I can't figure out which button's the right one. What I meant was... vertically, on the iron sight, is it at the bottom of the iron sight, at the top of the iron sight, or halfway between the top and the bottom? That's what I meant by middle. Obviously, it's the middle between the two. Or is it? I'm assuming it's between the two. All I know is I couldn't hit a damn thing with it. Was I poisoned? Am I poisoned? Too drunk to die? Hell yeah. And I seem to be not recovering health. I must have been poisoned. And I was supposed to... I'm going in and out of this bloody pit, boy. Right. Relax. Focus. And head towards the water. That's right. Head towards the water. And then go round. Head in towards the water. Yeah. I'm never going to make that shot. Joshua could make that shot. I'm not going to make that shot. Oh, I made the shot. Man with sword. Get the man with sword. Oh, man with sign. Oh! You're not the only one. You're not the only one doing sniper shots with a handgun. Why have I started calling it a handgun? Just because someone told me off for calling it a pistol. They're pistols, both of them.
Revolvers are not pistols. The absolute classification is...
They're both bloody pistols for me. Okay. It was still this way, wasn't it? Yes, because it was down a watery canyon. There. Come on. Three Marys. How the hell did that get its... Was that a rock fall? Because for a second I thought that was a white legs falling off the cliff. Which would have been slightly hilarious, except he probably would have landed and started shooting. So, wait a minute. Weren't we supposed to be leading an attack? Aren't we supposed to meet a bunch of people if we're leading an attack? This doesn't so much feel like leading an attack, and more kind of infiltrating and assassinating. And I'm not complaining about that, because honestly, the idea of about 10 of your guys legging it forward and getting slaughtered doesn't sound particularly good. That's not a white. Okay, that's kind of good, because whilst rain covered our approach, I suspect it was doing more to keep them hidden. Alright, your guys seem to be here already. Okay, we've discovered Three Marys and Cat Eyes. Bloody worn off. All right, we're here. What now?
The time for talk is past.
All right.
The Lord's work must...
Yes. I hope the Lord's work gets done before I run out of bloody cat eye.
Be done.
A pre-war toaster. Okay. We got a lot more of them.
Nah, don't... Name.
They're throwing three goddamn hatchets!
That's your bar.
What's that? clock and an empty soda bowl. Are you guys? Man with an axe. Fire axe. They like their axes and hatchets, don't they? They like them a lot. Nice one. I'm really giving serious thought to trying those out sometime. I bet I could roller skate. Oh god, dirty water. Why would I want dirty water? I don't. Bottle caps, on the other hand, I could always use. I can always find a use for bottle caps. Even 50. Oh god, I got loads of purified water. Did I loot all of these? No, I did not. And they do, in fact... I'm not sure if I can make anything with that. Weapon binding ritual, toxin. I should stop looting toxins. I believe I've got a fridge full of them. Yes, I keep them in my fridge. Because I couldn't think of anywhere else to put them. I put them in the chem box, but I was worried I would accidentally take them, whereas I'm a lot less likely to accidentally take something from the fridge. Which probably says a lot about me. And what it says is probably not that good. Microscope. Okay. Oh, God. I was hoping there might be a nice little slopey bit there. But apparently not. Okay, how far have we come? Okay, so I'm just going to keep following the canyon round. I'm going to pass a big open area, then we're going to keep going left, left, left. And when we finally turn right, that is when stuff is going to start getting real. I think. Did I read that correctly? Yeah. Just keep going down here. Shooting anything that pops up. Okay. The man did say this is an exterminate mission. I'm not liking this. Can I get up?
Yes.
Yes, what? Yes, what? Do not feel good? Like, first bath you've had for a long time or something? I don't know, I would. What the f-
This is taking too long. We can't let salt upon wounds escape. I'm going to find a way around. God willing, we will finish this together.
Hey, but Joshua Graham has left your company. You've lost Joshua's perk. What? Okay, so it was a booby trap. Can we not get back? Is that what you... I can get back. I can just climb over. It's dead easy, but out of... So, he just suddenly decided it was taking too long. We can still get there. What? Oh, the explosion was ahead. I thought it was. I thought it was for a second. What is he talking about? It took too long. Well, then what the hell am I supposed to do? Okay. He said... What? Locate the White Legs leader, Saltman, and deal with him. I would love to, but it's sending me... Oh, I've got to get up there, have I? Ah, right. That's a little creepy. Ah, okay. Oh, is there going to be a, like, nice little tunnel? And he's complaining it was taking too long. Three Mary's cabin, of course, is a cabin. He was What did he expect? Me to just run down the middle of the canyon? Maybe I should have held two pistols and screamed yippee-ki-yay or something.
He's taking too long.
I've heard that before. Now, I should try and take you out quietly. What the? I could have sworn I shot right through. But never mind. Right. Is that a... Okay, that's a pretty extravagant submachine gun, really, for... Okay, let's not say savages. But you get what I'm saying. For people who are dressed in a loincloth and war paint, mind you. Not that far off the Legion, really. Oh god, Cat Eye has worn off. Of course it has! I need it. It actually looks a little... lighter in here than it did out there in the rain. I may have spoken too soon. And yes, I'm still sneaking. Yes, I'm still taking my time. What's the saying? Fools rush in where angels fear to tread. Why do angels tread anyway? Surely they have wings. Should you just like fly in there? I'm really beginning to think that Cat Eye might have been a good idea. Where the hell am I going? That way. I.e., not this way, and yet... Here I am. Oh! Because you never know what you might find. An ashtray, for example. Explosive crate. A locked explosive crate. One frag grenade. I mean, who does that? I have a grenade! I have a frag grenade! I better lock it in a case in case somebody steals it. It's a bloody frag grenade. I should probably turn... No, I probably shouldn't. It really is down. I could... Switch to the Cat Eye again, but I don't have much left, and I don't know how much more I'm going to need. And it's actually more useful outside than it... Okay. That's the exit. Was there anything I missed? You know, a nice supply of bullets. For example. For that. No. I did loot you, didn't I? Yes, I did. Okay, fine. So we're heading out. I think I'm going to go out with my shotgun in hand in case there's something right on the other side. Because you never know, might be. Really? Fall over? Okay, that's really disturbing. Oh god, I really need to put your friend out of my No, no. I got other things to do. Don't mind me. Okay, that's just strange. He just stood there with blood spurting out of his neck. Thank you. What? Did his head fall off? Did I shoot you through the neck in such a way that it decapitated you? And yet you were so stunned. The universe itself was so stunned it didn't have time to let you fall over. You got stuck in a trap, didn't you? You got stuck in a trap. And oh my god, it's dark. Should have probably done this during the day, but you know. Cat eye there. Dehydration level has... There you go. Oh, wait. Okay, that's twisted. That is very, very twisted. I just drank water that's probably got the blood of my enemies. I can try and pretend that it was a deliberate act of macho-ness. Yes, I'm drinking the blood of my... Okay, never mind. Going up here, aren't we? Yeah. Nicely well-lit place. Please come this way. And step on the tripwire. Hey. The father of the caves didn't manage to get one past me. Actually, he did. He got one mine past me, but I managed to escape it. I'd like to think if I can bypass his traps. Nice try. Very nice try. And... what's in the crate? Let me guess. One potato or something? No! Might as well have been. Explosives. Fragrant. Why is this one not locked away? This one not as valuable as the last one? The last one had sentimental value? How the hell am I supposed to be getting down there? Because option A seems to be... oh god. Fall off. And I'm not particularly in love with option A. I'm supposed to be going that way. Came in that's the caverns. Then I'm supposed to be going this way. So I'm not supposed to be coming up here. I'm supposed to be going down there. No, wasn't it? Didn't I come out of... I came out of the cavern there. Yes, I did. Am I supposed to go that way? Maybe. Probably. Or this way. This way could work. Oh yeah, this way definitely looking hopeful. Depending on how you define hopeful, of course. Coffee machine, radio. So, where is everybody? It's supposed to be a war party, sort of a small army of them, surely. I mean, I've shot a few, but unless Joshua's been here before me. Okay, so it is the other way. Should probably have realized that. still, always nice to check.
Flickery water.
That still nauseates me a little. Look like a white leg. That looks like a white leg, and he just got shoved off a cliff. Right, which makes me think the other guy up here wasn't a white leg. Okay, they're executing the prisoners. Okay, brilliant, well done. Really wish you'd change that cloth. I'd feel much happier if the people on my side were all using guns. I realise that shows my cultural bias. Although I'd like to think of it as more of a bias towards, you know, reality. Are we going up here? I see a torch. I also see a friend with a gun. Cat eye's worn off. God damn it. This stuff just does not last very long at all. Anti-venom. Not really needed that much of that, actually. Am I on the right track? Are the conveniently placed torches indicating that the way to go? Or the way to, you know, a trap? Or to accidentally fall off a cliff? Or perhaps both? I guess I'm just going down. And obviously what I mean by that is, why is nobody shooting at me? This is almost creepier than the Sierra Madre. But in sort of like the opposite way. In Sierra Madre, I spent most of my time worried about... You look like a white leg. You've got white legs, and you've got the black head dress thing. Now you've got a hole in the top of your head. Where were you? I saw you. Oh, really? Ow! That didn't get him. That did not get him. Oh! He stopped as there was... Did I actually hit him? Yes, I did. How the hell do I get down there without dying horribly? Because they look like... Oh, that'll do, that'll do, that'll do. Okay. Machete, pinion nuts. Datura anti-venom. Is that better than... the other anti-venom, or is it specifically for the Datura toxin? I'm gonna put cat eye back on, I really am. I hope there's not much further to go, otherwise I'm going to be doing it in the dark. The night sky when you've taken cat eye, it's pretty trippy, actually. Falling rocks. Yeah, I know what you mean. Another camp. I'll tell you what, the night sky might be a little trippy, but the water certainly is. Okay, another way up there. Can I not get up there? Oh, maybe I have to go over the top. Very possibly. That is... never gonna make that show. Oh, come on. Really? Oh! Didn't want to shoot him with a rifle anyway! What the hell was that sound? Wasn't there somebody up here? Did I imagine... a person? No! Ho! Oh. Thank God I'm a lousy shot, I guess. Oh. All that... Okay. How do I... Aha. So... why am I here? You guys seem to have got this completely under control. I've killed a few of them, but not many. I'm just... I get the feeling I should just do exactly what I said before. Run down the center of the canyon, screaming something cool. Or not. Okay. Yippee-ki-yay! There you go. Something cool. Fire axe? No. Come on, we've got to be close to the end now. Oh, of course. I said when it turns right, didn't I? I got past the rock slide. There we go. Go. Okay, then we want to make sure that we're prepared for this. Yes, we do. For example. Okay, what? What? No. Was it bad whiskey?
We warned you at Syracuse, and you persisted.
Okay.
You took advantage of us at New Canaan to drive us out. And like the dogs of Caesar you are, you followed us to Zion. And now you stand on holy ground, a temple to God's glory on earth. The only use for an animal in our temple is sacrifice. Kale wachane conserva o. You understand me, don't you? Don't you?
Outman! Kunaman, mad! He kill all white legs. You talk. You stop.
Why would I do that? Why would I do that? Whoa, this isn't what I signed up for. Let me talk to Joshua. You're right. We're going to kill you, but not like this. Defend yourself. None of the above. I mean... Well, to be honest, though, I was expecting a war. I was expecting to kill lots of you as we came in here in a pitched battle. I didn't really expect to have a few stragglers to shoot and then find you guys on your knees getting shot in the back of the head. I'll talk to Joshua, but to be honest, mate, you kind of had it coming.
Him hear you. You talk.
Don't listen to this thing. His cries are those of a mad beast caught in a thicket. He gave no mercy to my family, and I will give none to his.
Yeah, I'm kind of with him on this. Let him keep his dignity. Give him a fighting chance. That sounds kind of stupid, though. No objections. Well, the thing is you should give him his dignity. Look. You should always treat people like people, not like animals, and just... Yeah, we're going to kill him anyway, aren't we? We're going to kill him. Give him a fighting chance. Just sounds silly. We should at least let him... I mean, what's he going to do? Let's kill him. Let him keep his dignity. Right, let him. Give him a fighting chance. We'll kill him anyway. It's better than treating him like animals. I don't like this whole shooting people while they're on their knees, begging for their lives kind of thing, really.
He never had any dignity to begin with. None of them did. But for your sake, for the sorrow's sake, I'll let him die on his feet.
Good man.
Stand up and look at what's come for you.
Okay. He's got friends.
It's the same end you would have had if he had died on his knees. But I suppose this was for the sake of the dead horses.
I've got a head wound.
Still, thanks to your help and the grace of God, the White Legs won't be troubling Zion anymore. Let's go find Daniel. Tomorrow we'll be here soon enough. And there is much to do.
I've got a head wound! Okay, no, I'm okay now.
And so it was that the conflict between the New Canaanites and the White Legs was finally resolved. The courier's involvement had tipped the scale, shifting the fragile balance of power.
Despite their defeat at Three Marys and the death of their war chief, the White Legs were determined to pursue the other New Canaanites. But when they finally tracked down their prey in Colorado, they discovered the tables had been turned. The White Legs who survived the New Canaanites' ambushes were hunted down by dead horses before they could reach the safety of the Great Salt Lake. When word of the White Legs' diminished numbers reached the 80s tribe, war was declared. And by year's end, the White Legs had been wiped out.
The Sorrows fought beside Joshua Graham and the dead horses, eradicating the threat the White Legs posed to Zion. When the courier and Joshua Graham felled Salt Upon Wounds, their victory was celebrated with a great feast. The Sorrows' transformation from a peaceful, timid tribe into a proud and warlike people broke Daniel's heart. He tried to take solace in the knowledge that they would remain in Zion. But it was a small comfort. The Sorrow's innocence was lost.
Having helped eradicate the White Legs from Zion, the dead horses returned to Dead Horse Point in triumph. They remained neutral toward the Sorrows, but as years went on, there were periods of competitive friction, even violence between the tribes. The New Canaanites, Daniel especially, intervened regularly as mediators, but found it difficult to reconcile the tribe's conflicts.
The defeat of the White Legs in Zion marked a turning point in the fortunes of the Happy Trails Caravan Company. Every 2 months, the caravan met with the New Canaanites in Zion Valley to trade. Happy Trails soon returned to prosperity. The vigilance of the Sorrows and Dead Horses in defending southwestern Utah, initially startling to Happy Trails caravans, soon proved a blessing. The tribes united against the 80s, driving them back from Highway 50, and thus opening yet another trading route for Happy Trails caravans.
Waking Cloud was distraught when she learned of her husband's death, but took comfort from her tribe and the compassion of the new Canaanites. She forgave Daniel for having concealed her husband's fate from her, and learned to accept his fate. When her grief faded, she took a husband from the Dead Horse tribe. At her bidding, he stayed close to home.
Though the courier had stopped Joshua Graham from executing Salt Upon Wounds, the war chief still fell in battle. The Whitelegs defeated at Three Marys. Joshua led the Sorrows and Dead Horses in tending to their comrades and burning the corpses of their foes. He continued to advocate militant opposition to the enemies of New Canaan and showed little quarter to those he fought. And yet he was changed. He no longer reveled in the brutality and cruelty for which he had been known in his former life. His inner demons, if not extinguished, were at the least appeased.
For years after the defeat of the Whitelegs, Daniel did his best to minister to the Sorrows' spiritual needs. Try as he might, he could not hold back the tribe's increasing militancy and reverence of Joshua Graham. Demoralized, he returned to his family and Dead Horse Point. His failures haunted him for the rest of his days.
And with that, the courier walked out of the history of the tribes of Zion and back to the gathering storm of the Mojave Wasteland.
Yippee-yay, there'll be no wedding bells for today.
Almost there. Almost there.
That jingle, jangle, jangle.
Civilization! The van! I've missed you. I have missed you so very much. Big hug. Oh, the van with all its ammo and alcohol. And Vegas! Civilization! Oh, I've missed you too. Oh, what a beautiful sight. Well, not exactly beautiful, but still. Oh, I've missed you. Oh, and I've got plans for you. I have got big plans for you. Yes, we're going to have Civilization Plus. I've had the best idea ever. We're going to expand Prim. You know what we're going to do? We're going to build a movie house. I think they called it a cinema. Yes. We're going to build a cinema in Prim. We're going to get loads of people. And I know just the place to get some, I don't know, old projector equipment. There's a drive-through somewhere south.